drugs.
Straight as an arrow, buddy.
You do drugs.
When have you ever seen me do drugs?
Last night, you were smoking pot.
Oh, yeah, well, I smoke pot, but I don't do drugs. There's a big difference
there. Pot is a drug.
Pot's not a drug. Cocaine's a drug. Acid's a drug. Pot's like coffee.
Pot's nothing like coffee.
Just like coffee. Boy, you gotta have it to go to work. Best part of waking up. Zigzags in your day.
Okay, let me point out this one crucial difference. Coffee is legal. Pot is illegal.
Oh, the law. You're going to throw that up in my face.
Yes, the law might throw it up in your face.
What about the law? When did you pay your taxes last?
Well, look, Rick, it's a dangerous drug.
Oh,
pot's not dangerous.
Sure.
You're going to hurt yourself smoking marijuana. Oh, what are you going to do, smoke the joint too long? God damn it, oh, I burned my fingers. Yahoo! Make that shit illegal. I hurt myself. Woo! Look at that. I burned my fingerprints off. That's why the government doesn't want you to have it, because it burns your fingerprints off. You one of them blank thumb potheads, aren't you, buddy?
Well, it doesn't make you paranoid. I guess that is dispelled. Look, it's a mild hallucinogen. Mild, admittedly, but a hallucinogen.
Maybe it makes HBO movies funnier. That's about all.
If you're sitting there laughing at Chevy Chase, you ought not to be smoking the shit. That's my opinion.
Well, how else you gonna laugh at Chevy Chase?
Well, you don't have to watch. You can turn that.
Yeah, it's not like you talk about hallucinogens, like acid. That's a hallucinogen.
And pot's a mild hallucinogen.
Oh, nobody smokes pot think they can fly. Goodness.
Well, that's hardly.
That pot smoker's damn happy he can't fly.
Why is that?
That's just one less decision you got to deal with.
Well,
yeah, you're stoned on pot. You're sitting on the ledge of that building for an hour and a half going. Yeah, well, I know I can fly, but where do I need to go that badly anyway?
I bet I know.
The refrigerator.
Yeah.
Oh, moon pie.
Red, put the moon pie back. We don't do mime.
You don't like my mime?
I don't like your mime.
I do mime, you know.
I had a feeling.
I studied at the Sorbonne in France.
Well, you know, I would find mime.
The Sorbonne. Somebody mocked me back there. And you let him get away with it. You know, pal.
Well, long line. Look.
Sham pal my ass. Sham fair weather pal, I say.
Look, Rick, we don't do mine. Mine's no good.
I do real good mine. I do working class mine. Blue collar mine.
Blue collar mine.
Mine for the working man.
And so I just know what blue collar means.
I was just clearing it up. Okay. Mr. Bourgeois Strumpet.
Okay.
Mime is this classic mime piece adopted for men that have jobs.
Have you ever seen that classic mime piece, the Mime in a Box?
Yeah, that's how I do that one.
You do
Rick in a Box.
Rick in a Box.
Seen it? Rick in a... Hey! Somebody didn't make this corner flush! Look at this!
Rick!
There's a blonde hair right there, buddy! Come on!
Rick!
You ain't leaving here until we sweep the goddamn woodshed!
You're not supposed to talk there in mime. I was looking.
How am I going to tell the guys that they screwed up the job if I can't talk?
Well, that's the only reason I let you do it, is I thought you were going to be quiet for a second. You're not supposed to talk there in mime.
I have one that I don't talk in.
You don't talk.
You ever seen this classic mime piece?
Hauling a rope.
Hauling cable.
Okay. Rick hauling cable.
I whistle though. I can't whistle, but if I was a foreman, I could.
Okay.
That's what kept me from being a goddamn foreman. That and I didn't finish high school.
You're a high school dropout?
Well, I dropped out of seventh grade, actually. Okay. Hey, you got a cigarette on you? Another one?
I'm running kind of low, if that's okay.
I'll just smoke one of my own, then.
You could have been a foreman.
You can walk away from the truth, friend, but for how long, huh, pal? It'll follow you home tonight. It'll follow you into that restroom. You'll wake up next to it in the morning.
Rick, let's get back to... marijuana, you know.
Okay.
A lot of the discussion of marijuana. A lot of people would argue, and I would be among them, that smoking marijuana can lead to the use of heavier, more dangerous.
Oh, drugs. Oh, contraire.
Oh, contraire.
Contraire. That's French for bullshit, pal.
No, it is.
I'm calling you on it. There's the line, buddy. Cross that line.
It's not. That's au contraire, is it, French?
Oh yeah, con is French from the Latin root bull. A con being a bull. When you con somebody, oh, bull, that's a con. Traire, meaning as in the bowels, the trail of the bowels. Contraire. Bullshit! I read dictionaries.
Okay. While you're stoned, I'm totally wrong about marijuana having bad effects here, obviously. It leads to the use of heroin.
No, it's just the opposite is true.
Au contraire.
Yes, sirree, au contraire. 180 degrees gives me the strength to say nope to dope.
How does that work? I don't understand.
Well, you get you a couple hits off a real good number.
It has to be a real good
tie stick. Well, it helps.
No, okay.
A couple hits off that, spending that $100 for a gram of cocaine is about the last thing on your mind. I just kind of sit here and do my impression of a couch.
If I were to offer you cocaine at this moment,
I'd love to get that money out of my wallet and give it to you for that coke, dude.
Dude.
That means I'd have to stand up. In a nutshell.
Okay. Well, if I was to follow this bizarre logic of yours, you would argue that if everybody was stoned on pot, we wouldn't have this crack epidemic.
Oh, no, no. You get rid of crack houses overnight.
No more crack houses.
Replace them with roach motels. Check in, just kind of forget you're there. Am I still here? All right.
You probably would argue we ought to legalize marijuana.
Legalize it, buddy. Legalize it. Dope smokers don't belong in jail. We need jail space for criminals.
Okay, well,
bankers! SNL fraud.
All right.
We're gonna have to be kicking potheads out by the dozens. Come on, we got some white collar crime coming in here.
Like the SNL plays a large role in your life. Look, Rick.
I got a job, pal. I have to drive through something every Friday afternoon at 2.
Okay.
The hell you think I drive through? A liquor store?
It's savings and loan. You don't save shit. And I can't imagine anybody in their right mind loaning you anything. Look, Rick.
Right mind being a key phrase there.
Right. Look, legalize it. You would legalize it.
Oh, legalize it and tax it and get rid of that budget deficit in about a week and a half. Yeah. Like that's our fault. Yeah. Gee, I'm talking about just what I smoke.
That's assuming you remember to send in the...
You just pay your taxes on zigzags.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
All wrapped up.
Oh, yeah, I'm a party fella.
You're a party fella. I think you need to set the next scene.
All right.